A quick start guide to pumps. Today we'll be taking a quick look at modelling pumps in the Pipeflow Expert software. Let's first add a pump to the pipe and open the pump data screen. For a more detailed look at all the pump modelling features the software has to offer, check out our pump modelling series in the software video section on pipeflow.com. To get started, there are three main pump modelling methods. You can define a fixed flow rate, a fixed head increase, or specify a flow versus pressure loss performance curve for a set speed. An appropriate name, image, colour and scale can be selected to visually represent your pump on the drawing. This has no bearing on the mathematical calculation. First, looking at the fixed flow pump. This pump type is used to specify the pump flow rate for a positive displacement pump. The system will be solved and the required head from the pump will be calculated. In this example, we see that the pump would need to add about 22.25 feet of head to produce the 183.8 US gallons per minute flow rate we set. A fixed head increase is used to specify a fixed amount of pressure that the pump will add into the system. When the system is solved, Pipeflow Expert takes into account all other flows and pressures throughout the model and calculates the flow produced by the pump. Using a fixed head increase can be useful when troubleshooting your system. For example, you may solve your model and realize that the pump you have added does not produce enough head to meet the requirements of the model. You could then set a pump to a large fixed head value and then gradually reduce this until the requirements are met. The software will then report the flow rate produced for the amount of head specified, and this data can be used to select a more appropriate pump. Often a pump manufacturer will provide you with a range of flow versus head loss data, which can be entered into the pump data table when the set speed option is selected. We will finish entering the data points for this particular pump and click Draw Graph. The operating curve is then drawn on the pump data screen. The pump will produce a flow rate and a pump head to match the frictional resistance throughout the system. The duty point will be identified on the performance curve for the operating speed of the pump. More complex pump graph options can be produced, which include speed and impeller diameter adjustments, together with ISO lines to display an efficiency map for the pump. We would recommend taking a look at the range of pump tutorial videos available on our website for more complex examples. If you are looking to size a centrifugal pump, a fixed flow rate pump can be used. Let's set this pump to a fixed flow rate of 3.1 feet cubed per second. Save this back to the pipe and solve the system. Now, hovering over the pump, we can see that the head increase required by this pump is about 18 feet head. We can then select a centrifugal pump that meets this flow and head requirement from our preferred pump manufacturer, or search the generic pump database available within the software. You can search for an appropriate pump that can add 18 feet amount of head for a 3.1 feet cubed per second flow rate, and look for pumps with best efficiency. The software will bring up a selection of pumps found in the library that meet this criteria. Double-clicking any of these will add the data to the pump data screen. We can now save this pump back to the pipe and recalculate. Hovering over the pump, Pipeflow Expert shows us that this pump will operate at 3.09 feet cubed per second and add a head of 18.005 feet. As mentioned, there are many more detailed videos on pump modelling available on our website, where we look at defining our pump data by importing an image of a manufacturer's pump graph. We also have a video looking at the pump predicted performance when varying speeds and changing impeller diameters. Further refinements can be made to define the pump performance data to make the pump model more closely matched to the manufacturer data, and we look at this in greater detail in another video. Thanks again for watching, and do check out our pump modelling series on pipeflow.com.